Shauna heals by like 12 or 18. I'm not sure which.
18. I think she got 3 hits.
Yeah, you did get 3. Everything hits you except for the fourth one, which misses. So Shauna regenerates 18. The cleric who's with her regenerates 6, and Deer regenerates 6. Thank you, Kenyon. I would have gone the rest.
Be a while on this little laptop, on this little internet.
Countered as large before, so that's nothing new.
Is the changes into your strength are factored into the spell? You don't change your strength as well as change your strength.
I think tricrines start at 11 feet long.
Yeah, they're large to begin with.
Oh, I crit him. Minimum damage. Aww. Okay. Wait a minute. Okay, one giant dead. All right. She's just in danger of being completely outflanked. Now I have a question. If I run off from this one, I get an opportunity attack. It'll probably chop off another 20 of my hit points. But I could get up and kill that one. Ayana has already injured. Ayana's turn's coming up anyway. She'll probably one hit that one, then turn over to other targets. Let me just check something real quick. Okay, does Deer have a 10-foot reach?
Still have attacks? That's going on?
Yeah, he's got That was just two of three arm attacks. So he has one more upper arm attack, two lower arm attacks, and then three bites because it's his off turn. Okay, do you guys think that an enlarged strike ring would be able to affect a 10-foot reach with a weapon?
Well, a human-sized character with a two-handed weapon can, in fact, like a pole arm, can, in fact, have a 10-foot reach being reached with a weapon. Loud. Basically grown to a height slash length of 15 feet.
15 feet, yeah. So he's gaining, I think, over 3 feet. So be 5 foot length he would gain. Round up.
He gained about 4 feet, but he's about 11 feet tall and he gained somewhere along the lines of 4 feet. Basically, a Nunchaku, which has a good reach.
He was about 7 feet, now he's 9 feet tall. He was 11 feet long, now he's about 14 feet long.
In these two half giants, so long as he doesn't technically leave the reach of the first half giant, he won't get an opportunity attack. He's gonna move up here. Here's the plan.
Can't hear you.
Nope, still cut out. I'd have to go text there, Sil.
It sounds like you don't have the mic near you.
Okay, how about now?
Much better, much better.
Much better.
Okay, here's the plan. Instead of attacking this one, which is close to me, I'm going to attack this one. And you might say, what's the difference? They both have full health. The idea is, by dumping the rest of my attacks into this one, I will damage it low enough for Ayana's attacks that are left over from killing this guy to kill this guy as well. If I just dump all my attacks into this guy, Ayana won't be able to get over here and finish this one off because she'll get opportunity attacks from these three, well, these five. So, you see what I'm going for here?
And your position has still got this thing facing away from Derek. And anyone else who comes from this area angle. Ranged people, bear in mind, these guys are all in melee with an ally. And also, dead allies are large. We cannot fire into melee here, unless you have some kind of, say, I'm not aware of, that lets you fire into melee.
I'd expect making a called shot will let you shoot into melee, but that's what, -4 to hit, and -2 to, or +2 to initiative or something like that.
Well, when I'm running, there is, in fact, that basically suits the proficiency I allow for a style specialization for firing to the melee. But, I'm just playing in John's backyard, so I'm going to play by his rules and enjoy it.
Okay, I don't think it matters much. I'm going to declare the movement I made along to get up here a charge. It makes my deck, my armor class go from 2 to 5, but I really don't think that's going to matter, and I want the +2.
Charge one and everything like that?
Seems kind of short for a charge, but oh well.
I would suggest doing a stop.
He was
leap
here.
High, flip your own. Flip your own.
And the jump would still count as a charge, yeah.
Slap down.
Yeah. Down.
I needed this one. That plus two.
A creener nasty in that regard.
Purdy.
Okay, we
plus
are
30%.
Going with Stinging Six.
30%.
I needed that plus two, see guys? Good decisions being made here. I needed that plus two.
And they're pretty much going to hit you if they try, so it's not too big of a loss.
We're at 43 damage total so far on this guy. Over half his health is gone. Now we're going for the bites, yeah. No poison today.
Hey, I'm in a voice game. Call me later, okay? Bye.
Oh, wait, yeah, you'd have to shoot past Ingana. You're a crane. You probably have enough movement to rush up behind him and gouge his eyes out if you want to, but remember, that's at your own risk.
Well, Iona's 14 feet tall. This guy is 20 feet tall, so there's plenty of range to shoot over her.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure you could shoot over her if you wanted to. Like, what's the worst that can happen? You get stuck on her ponytail? Hey, I wonder what happens. What do you think would happen if, like, Boris got, like, 500 really low-level defilers together and had them all cast enlarge on him?
The highest level one would be the one that kicked in. It would not do nothing.
Oh, that's lame. I was thinking he'd get so big he'd shatter the crystal sphere.
No, he'd need to be multiple orders of magnitude bigger than that.
But yeah, the one that has Zier's back profile is on full health. He's got 75 hit points. If you think you can, like, you know, disable him somehow, feel free. But there is one on 3 health on the other side of Ayana, which would, you know, be easy to take out.
I think our DM has ruled that one size category larger submission with fire save.
Was supposed to be the chill giant fight. Unsurprisingly, when you have to deal with these things all at once, you know, they're not as easy to take care of as if they come up to you one at a time. What did we learn, Ball?
Mal did not back up quite far enough to the door.
I don't think me and Avantion actually meant to just ditch you. We figured you were gonna pull out just as far as we do. I would have helped you onto the roof.
They're leading the way.
Well, there were two of them between me and the exit, so.
Oh, is that a fact? They must have had their initiatives between us. Oh, that really sucks. If I'd seen that, I probably wouldn't have just pulled out. I probably would have tried to clear you a path.
Yeah, it's kind of dark and those bugs look alike. It sounded speciesist.
Okay,
Was that your uncle or was that your auntie? You all look alike, it's so hard to tell.
Hands up, what penalty do you think there'd be for shooting the one that's passing on 3 HP that really needs to die?
Strictly by the book, you would count him as 2, strictly by the book, you would...
Is in melee with 2, so they'd have to roll a. Ayana would be 1 to 2, the hurt one would be 3, 4, 5, 6, and the unhurt one would be 7, 8, 9, 10. Or something like that.
You roll manually to determine the actual target.
Oh, so what you're telling me is there's basically zero chance that arrow would find its target, and the only way that we could assassinate that one specific target is if, you know, Kurtik ran in there headlong, went around the entire pack, and specifically attacked that one behind.
Could have a 40% chance of hitting his desired target. 20% chance of hitting me, and 40% chance of hitting the other target.
Okay, how do you like those odds, Evangeon? The just something about seeing that great big red X over that one giant. It's just very satisfying to me. Okay, that's clever.
Yes, it is. Oh, something clever happened. There.
Well, I mean, you know, theoretically.
Yourself?
90 yards is 270 feet. You should be fine.
Yeah.
Gotta remember that Avignon's down under, he uses metric.
Just to convert yards to meters and you're fine. Officers, would you mind if we take a, like, 15-minute nibbles break? We'll try and get back sooner than that, but we're running out of stuff in the house, and I want to run to McDonald's or Wendy's before they close.
I'm game.
Shod myself and be back in a while.
Yeah, we could go for a bit of a break.
Thank you.
Okay, yeah, you absolutely have rear shot from there. And if you're specializing in bow, you probably get point blank. Yeah, I think that might be point blank. Alright, so without specialization, you'll get the plus two for shooting in the back. You need one hit to have two shots. That hits by four. You need three damage. Three damage, and you will have killed that eagle-headed giant. You must be joking. Yeah, you're gonna need another shot. You're gonna need another. You got pretty good odds, all things considered. No, you don't lose the plus two. He can't turn around. It's not his turn. Not to mention, if he turns around, Ayana's just gonna slit his throat.
Well, jab him in the kidney, probably, because she can't reach his throat. But...
that is exactly what you needed to hit. He's dead. Okay, he is on 25 health. Fitz, can you do 25 damage?
No, but I'm going to try to lasso this big one in front of me.
You know, I must say, I do respect the hustle.
I think that's a miss. That's all I got.
Well, if you assume that these guys aren't very nimble, his touch AC is probably 9 or 10. And you're not trying to get through his armor, you're just trying to get him. So that might be a hit.
You know, Adoni, you make a very good point. Tenchi was just saying that they're not very nimble, and they probably just rely on their thick skin. Do we want to rule them a touch AC of, say, 8, 9, 10?
Works for me.
Okay, so for the sake of argument, we'll say that the half-giant cowboy manages to land a hit. What precisely happens when you land a hit with that?
A girl,
yeah. I don't really know, other than you restrained them, and you got them to make a strength check.
Your rope's about to break, sorry there.
So I can hold them and restrain them some, which might make them easier to hit by others.
Okay, so let me think about what I just heard. So, you just made a strength check. You beat it by 5. So, from what I remember, when two people are making strength checks and both are likely to succeed, it's the biggest difference between the two scores that matters. So you have a difference of 5. You succeeded by 5 points, so you have 5. So, in order for him, who has, we're going to assume he has a strength of 25, if he rolls a check, he has to get a difference between his roll and the strength check that is greater than 5, which would mean he would have to roll a nat 20, which would be the worst possible roll to tie, and every other die roll, he would beat you by a mile.
Okay. So he needs a 20 fail.
Yeah, 20 ties, and tie goes to you, and everything else, 1 through 19, he's just too strong.
Okay.
Okay, was that against his legs? That was, wasn't it?
I didn't roll to see where it hit, but if you want to say that, that's fine.
It says that lassos that were all called shots, so that any attack with a lasso is a called shot, right?
That's according to player's option combat and tactics. I haven't looked at the arms equipment guide, but I don't know which one.
Please tell me you rolled with the minus 4 for call shot.
No, I did not.
Well, that would mean you miss anyway, so, because you
and
got a 12.
I wasn't doing it really as a called shot. I was doing it as to hit anything.
All right,
well,
so,
apparently you actually need to use called shots with lassos, at least according to player's option combat and tactics.
That's fine. Okay, so now what do we do? Do we refund his action, or do we just say he used a lasso as a called shot and missed by a mile?
It's by a mile.
We are missing a Tenshi. Hopefully he comes back eventually, because it's his turn right now.
He needed that 15-minute nibble thing.
Oh, all right. Okay, so there are...
He said he'd be back in 15 minutes. I know he was going to have Derek charge from behind on his kink with his lance.
You know, that might actually do 25 damage. What does he roll for that? He's got +2 charge, +2 from behind. So, what's his stacko?
I'm not sure. You have to check his character sheet.
Okay, I'm gonna... Let's see if I can find it. NPCs, no.
Click the token, you'll open it up.
Sweet, I didn't know that.
Shift-click the token?
Yeah.
Shift-double-click the token.
Okay, thanks. I did not know that. Okay, so his Thaco is... Oh, I don't need to know what his Thaco says on his sheet. What is he? He is a level... He is a level 5 fighter, which means his Thaco is 15. He has not updated it for his latest level. Wait, no, he has...
Thaco 5 is... Or, yeah. Level 5 is Thaco 16.
Yeah, I'm level 6. I have a Thaco 15. It's because it's right. 5.
You go to his weapon tab, it should be there, probably.
Yeah.
Breaking up again.
Okay, so I'm looking on his sheet. He says he has a heavy horse lance made of
Agafari wood or something. Doesn't matter. Lances don't need to be metal.
So it's
they
tempered.
Can do full damage. Okay, yeah. Doesn't matter. Still does the same damage regardless of material.
Okay, so I'll roll up. I'll give him a +4 on top of his normal bonuses. We'll see if it hits. No!
You can still roll a 2.
You must be joking. And he only gets one attack, right?
Right, on the charge,
right,
yeah.
Up there. Oh, he gets a +2 on the charge, doesn't he?
Yeah, that was with a +4. He's not looking so hot right now.
We rolled a 2, that's why.
Bad rolling could still only get you so far.
Okay, so let's see. What else can he do on his turn?
We've had a lot of good bad rolls lately.
Rolls seem to be kind of spiky. You know, we're seeing lots of crits. We're seeing lots of, bad things happen when we really don't need bad things to happen. You feel me? All right, so he's got... Oh, is this an off round? Yeah, this is the second round. So he has another attack. It's... A war pipe? Yeah, he has a war pipe on his person. It's also tempered. Let's see, what's its damage versus large? It's a D2 versus large. Oh, no. Wait, can't he just jab with the... No, he can't jab with the horse lance again. Because it's too heavy, right?
It's a heavy lance, yeah. Also, I think he was going for the one that was behind his ear.
Oh, all right. That makes more sense. Okay, so...
So I think that's probably it for his turn.
Yeah. This is gonna get funky. Okay, so... We're gonna start with this giant here. Tell me, what sounds more plausible to you? Is he gonna attack Zir, who he has the back of, or is he going to attack the guy who just charged him on a kank and stabbed him with a lance but didn't do any damage?
I think he'd be paying more attention to Zero.
Yeah, that makes sense to me. And he charged, he's got his back, so he's got a Thaco of like -3 right now. So I'm just gonna roll. Unless he gets I'm just gonna roll flat d20. Unless he gets a 1, it's an automatic hit pretty much no matter what. Yeah, that hits. He has a Thaco of like -3.
Oh, that's gonna be back there.
Hey, a fun fact. Those half giant fighters, they have a Thaco of 11, somewhere around there.
That beats Ayana's.
Ow. What did you miss? Tenchi's character completely botched a charge, and Zero just got hit in the back of the head for like a third of his health.
Also, Critic took down a giant with a couple arrows. Right, you were here for that because that was you.
That was Fitz. Where'd Fitz go?
Fitz was mega. Did he just drop out of the chat?
Yeah, the voice chat. Guys, I want to tell you, you are three kills away from the fattest dump of XP that has probably ever been seen by this server. All right, so that's that one's turn done. This one here is facing Ayana. So he'll take a crack at her. Hopefully it misses. Because his fight was a lot closer than I wanted it to be. This was supposed to be the relaxed fight. It was not the relaxed fight. Crap.
She's tough. She could take it.
You have more the help. You have more help than Dragob. I don't want to hear no whining.
No whining here.
Okay. So now. Now, we have the issue of the half-giant to the south. Not the half-giant, the beast-headed giant to the south. There is... I would really like to pull out a reason as for why he would not attack Fitz's cleric. But you and me both know that there is nobody else he would be going for right now. He's going to crack her one. And we're going to see if she dies. And if she does, we're all going to sigh together. She has an armor class of 2, so he has a 10% chance of missing her. We'll see how that goes. He did not miss her. So Now she gets 2d8 and 8. Okay, 13. She had,
I think she's still alive. And even conscious.
Okay, yeah, she's still up on 3 HP. Okay, that was... Ooh, ooh boy.
You select her character and it brings up the three circles. Yeah, you can just put a minus 13 in there and it'll subtract it.
All right. Looks like, yeah, this fight is pretty much over. There is no way those guys are living to have another turn after the sheer amount of disgusting punishment that Zier and Ayana can put out. Yeah. Yeah, they're looking a little better, aren't they? Now, let's see. Is it... Yeah, it's Laura's turn. What was her second level spell? That's the only one she has left. She has a second level spell. Let's see. What did I give her again? It's probably something really stupid that won't do anything. Okay. Where are you? I know I put your information here somewhere. Prep work. Yeah, this should be it. My prep work folder. Where is it? What spell do you have? Is it here? No, that's for the half giant. Where's this? Dang it. Maybe I'll just look through the list of second level spells. Maybe I'll recognize it. Deep pockets, detect invisibility. No, forget. Glitter dust, hypnotic pattern. Invisibility, irritation, knock, no, he's trapped, then take, okay, yeah, pass. Oh, I remember. It was Melf's acid arrow. Okay, so, she's going to cast Melf's acid arrow. We are going to see if it hits with a Thaco 17 against a mob with AC 3. That would be a, no. That's a no. So, Wizard is out of spells. Zier is up. And, he is, well, there's nothing else he can do but turn around and wail on the guy who's wailing on him. So he will just make an about face and start swinging. Oh, Fitz is back.
Now it's back.
Okay,
Miga Kare took a hit and took 13 damage from it, but I think she's still up.
Yeah, you're still up. You're on 3 health.
Okay.
Half of the giants are dead. There's only 3 left. We are on the third round. It is currently Zir's turn. He is wailing on a full health half... not half giant. Stop saying half giant. He is wailing on a full health Kira-headed giant right in front of him.
Okay, cool.
Gotta remember the 30% increase. Remember the 30% increase. Oh, Evangeline wants to get one of them alive. Yeah, I could respect that. What are your chances of getting one alive? Zir can probably do that. Yeah, he might be able to do that. It would just depend. Let me think. But yeah, all you would have to do is knock one down to zero health, but not so far down that it gets to negative 10. Like, yeah, as a matter of fact, that one you shot with your bow, he's not to negative 10. That eagle-headed one. If you prefer, I could, you know, roleplay him as not dead, but down, for your benefit. The eagle-headed one? Well, you're not sure if he's the leader, but he was the one in the front, which is, you know, kind of hints at it. How much damage did your second shot with that bow do? It was like 5, right?
Actually, since he moved, he only gets half his rate of fire. So he only gets one shot anyway.
Yeah, not this round. The last one when he downed the giant, he did 3 damage to it.
Yeah,
was
he moved. Right, he moved, and since he moved, he only got half of his rate of fire, so he gets one shot instead of 2.
Didn't he move at half speed?
Unless he's got missile style specialization, any moving at all halves your rate of fire. If he goes over half rate, he can't shoot at all. If he goes under half rate, he gets half his rate of fire.
Okay, then that giant is still up, and he gets a crack at you. I'm rolling up.
Okay. Right, and she's back.
I believe you can also call that your attacks be non-lethal.
Although that's very hard to do with bows.
Yeah. But he is a ranger. He's probably pretty skilled at that.
There's another 23.
Ooh, she's a ranger.
Okay.
She's definitely feeling it. But she's doing better than Mika Kari.
Okay. Evangeline. This guy is on one hit point. This eagle-headed giant, he is on one singular hit point. If you want one alive, I would suggest on your turn you rush up and conk him on the back of the head. Because, you know, Aeon is probably gonna obliterate him in one shot. I'm not gonna lie to you. So just as a recap, this one is on 1 hit point. This one here is on 25. And this one here is on full, but it's being attacked by Zir this turn.
And Threadcrane don't usually use unarmed attacks, but they can. So if you want to, they don't usually use punching attacks, but they can if they want to. And a punching attack will do 1 to 2 plus your damage bonus. I don't know what you roll to hit.
Normally, a punching attack will give him a free shot on you as you go into punch, but he's facing away, so I'm just not going to care about that. Like, for instance, if, say, Tenshi would, you know, like to wheel around and go for another charge, I would I would rule that since the giant is facing away, it doesn't get an opportunity attack. The only penalty for using the flat of one of your metal hand axes would be you do not get the specialization. You do not get specialization on a sword it's a tall shot to knock out. I would seriously suggest you use your natural weapons because you have 5 attacks with them and they do very little damage. Use your natural weapons, like your foreclaws, your bite, use that. Both my singing sticks miss by a mile because I'm, you know, fighting him like a man from the front, which is not good. Oh, my bites are missing now, too. Oh, that one hit. Let's see. Am I gonna get the poison?
I got the poison. He's paralyzed.
Nice. Awesome.
Let's see. He's huge. How much does he need? Where's the info on this? Yeah, here it is. Scroll into my sheet.
I'll probably have to sit there a few rounds and pump poison into him. So big.
Yeah, here we go. Okay. Huge creatures. Huge and gargantuan creatures. 1 round. Okay. So he loses his next turn, but that's it. Okay, so until his next turn, he is considered immobile. He cannot resist any attacks made against him, which means you can automatically hit him with any attacks you do on him. Also, because he is considered immobilized, attempts to knock him out also automatically hit because he is considered immobilized. He has basically no armor class. If you are not Ayana and you have trouble hitting things with 3 AC, I would suggest you attack this guy because you can hit him basically for free. Oh, I need to explain Tenshi. Yeah, Tenshi, you weren't here for your last turn. Adoni told me you were going to charge this one. This giant here that your code token's up against, you did get the charge for +4, but you rolled a 2 and whiffed it, but he hasn't attacked back yet. He focused on Seer.
Is that the one that is paralyzed now?
Yes, that would be this one right here. This one right here. If you have something that is very unlikely to hit, but if it does hit, it's going to do something really nasty, use it on that guy right now. Like 30-something. Yeah, Tenshi, we didn't know if you were like gone or just taking a break for certain. I'm sorry. I may have screwed up there. I wasn't paying as much attention as I should have been.
We did wait a while.
This one has 30 seconds.
Can you hear this, Derek? Can you hear this, Tenchi?
This one here has 37 hit points and is paralyzed. This one has one hit point and is facing this way. And these two are, well, this one here has 25 hit points and is facing this way. And this one has max hit points. I think Tenchi just disconnected again. His internet must be acting up.
He's still on the game hub, just not in the Red Cane kit, just not on Discord.
Oh, coming, yeah, he's coming back in.
I think
in.
He was having trouble with his sound, so he's trying to disconnect and see if that'll fix it.
I wouldn't be surprised. Oh, we hear him.
We can hear you now.
If you hit him once, he's down, and then he'll start bleeding out, but you'll have like 7 rounds to stabilize him and get him as a captain, so you're pretty safe so long as you only hit him with one of your claws. I am sorry if I come off like, you know, some kind of know-it-all. Like, I know that in the Dungeon Master's Guide it specifically says, if you are the DM, do not give the players tactical advice. But, you know, in this case, I don't want you to die. If you, like, prefer I not do that, that's fine. Just tell me, you know. I don't want to come across as patronizing. Yeah, you can do them in any order, so you could try and bite them. Yeah, I was wondering. I just wondered quietly to myself. I was thinking earlier, like, yeah, if they kill all these silt giants, like, Evangeion's character is not going to be able to find or even get to like the island that these silt giants live on. Yeah, I was going to say something. I thought that I was, you know, let you figure that out yourself. Okay. 1d4 plus 1.
Is the suggestion that his mate might still be alive?
Well, lucky Evangeion, this giant here.
Thank you.
No paralysis, but hey, he's down. That's what matters. And yep. now you still have all of your attacks. So if you want to, you know, whip your weapons back out, you still have some attacks if you want to put them anywhere. Okay, I'm cutting out. Am I cutting out still?
Currently. Been doing it a lot, though.
Okay, so right now, the bite comes free. You don't have to commit to natural attacks to use the bite. That comes free with your melee. So you can actually, you know, use whatever melee attacks you'd like of Angeon on any other target you like. They would be automatic hits on the paralyzed one. But you can take a crack at one with 25 health left to the south, or the full health one if you like. You have plenty choice of targets now. I'm kind of getting concerned. It doesn't look like we're going to get them all this round. If we don't, and another one manages to hit Fitz's character, yeah, we might be looking at the actual first entry into the obituaries.
To Fitz down to?
About three.
Three targets. One has 37 health and he's paralyzed. One has 25 health and you can get rear shots on him. Another one has 75 health and you can get rear shots on him. Okay, you're going for the big one.
Are you talking to me or Avignon?
I'm talking to Avignon. Your turn's up next. Okay. So he gets plus four because of charge and rear attacks with those hand axes. Very smart play by Evangeon to use the bite, because, you know, the bite, he could still use his hand axes even though he used the bite. Using a claw would have made him commit to all claws and bite. I didn't think of that. Yeah, I know. Not the eagle-headed one. The eagle-headed one is down. This is the eagle.
Can't hear you, Syl.
Bollocks.
Okay.
That came through.
Loud and clear.
Okay, can you hear me from here? Can you hear me from here? Does this work?
Yes, that works. Right.
Yes.
Okay, I'm just going to stay in this position and hopefully it works. So this eagle-headed one, he's not dead. I'm going to give him a different marker. We'll go with that one. It's tiny, you can barely see it. But it's down there in the left, right corner. He's on neg one. Okay, so your targets are this one, which has 25 hit points. You can get charge and rear attack on it for plus four. This one is paralyzed and has 37 hit points. You can get guaranteed hits on it. This one has 75 hit points. He's on full health, and you can get him charge and from behind for plus four. Any of those three targets is fine. Yep, you get plus four on all of your attacks to hit that guy because he is facing away from you. And if you manage to do 25 damage, he'll be history. Alright, show me some dice. Plus four to hit. Armor class three. That's enough. It's like a cosmic joke. It really is. That one hits too. It hurts me. I'm in pain right now. Okay, he's on 23 health. He has 23 hit points remaining.
Which one?
Oh, he's got another one. Yeah, this one that Evangeion has circled here, he's hacking it into him from behind with his hand axes. Not doing much, but he's chipping its health down. He just got another hit on him. That's much more like it. Now he's on 20 health.
If this thing didn't even touch me. The turn, not this turn, I didn't find out yet.
Yeah, it hasn't, the one you're up against, it's paralyzed. Huh? It's not going to get to touch you. Look, if you want to pull up.
Yeah, I might switch. Hey, I was stuck on my lance in hand, right?
Yeah, you still got your lance. You can, like, that charging attack you want to do, you can do it for free now. It's a guaranteed hit. He's paralyzed.
Oh, no. I would charge this guy, and we can, okay, I'm going to go, like, he's not going to be paralyzed for very long, is he?
This guy that you're on? This guy here is paralyzed until his next turn. Like, when his turn comes up, he won't be able to do anything. But after that, he will be considered free moving. Until then, until initiative 17 of this turn, he is considered paralyzed, and all your attacks on him are auto hits. Okay, wow, Evangeion did another 3 damage. He's down to 17 now.
Calm down.
Oh, yeah, you were. I did think I saw a minus one on your attacks there, Evangeion. So that means you did 4, 8, 10, 12 damage, which means he is on 13 health, not 17. Okay, so Ayana, I'm pretty sure I don't need to repeat your choice of targets again. Probably gotten quite bored of that. So I'm just going to let you, you know, do what you do best. That is seriously unfortunate.
And we can't hear you if you're talking.
This mic, man. Please do not let Ayana's second attack miss. We need this guy dead. That hits.
Okay, and she's aiming at this one with her second attack.
All right. He's on full health, but he's not going to be for a minute or two. This is probably going to chop off half his health.
And it'll get his attention.
Oh.
Importantly.
Yeah, I respect the play. He could have went for the kill. Yeah, I respect that play. That's 26, I think. Just guessing off the top of my head. Oh. Yeah, I was a little overgenerous there. 24, so he's on 51. So, 51, 13, 37, and paralyzed.
So, Megakare is going to do a defensive withdrawal. About this far, and then cast Cure Light Wounds on herself.
Yeah, I respect the play. That's probably what I would have done on the first turn, but, you know.
Okay. If I know, will this guy still be paralyzed and Zill's next round comes up?
Would you know? I don't think so. You wouldn't know.
She's got 9 hit points.
Well, as much as I want to take the opportunity to charge this big guy here with a lance... Jarrett drops the lance and he draws Iron Bone. Do a coup de grace, or does he need to hit the guy while he's paralyzed?
Yeah, you can get
I think it's an auto hit, but he's kind of tall to coup de grace here, I think.
Yeah, that'd be true. Unless he'd be paralyzed. He wouldn't, like, he'd probably topple over were it a real world situation, but paralyzation does not automatically mean prone in this game, so. Yeah, you'd get an automatic hit. You don't need to roll for hits. Just go straight to damage.
Okay. So Derek rises in the saddle and slams Iron Bone into the side of this monster's knee. Just destroyed him, by the way. And next round, if we're still going, he gets 2 attacks from Iron Bone. Right, there's Derek.
Oh, man. There's going to be...
you.
How much?
Slow up my sheet. You're dragging again.
I was worried there for a second. For like 1 second, I was worried there. Then I opened Ayana's character sheet. I was like, no, not worried.
I'm worried about Ayana, at least.
I was like, Can she take 50 more damage this turn? That's what it's going to be. It's going to be 50 more damage. And I opened her feet up. She has 177 max health. She is sitting pretty on what is probably double the max health of anyone else here, and she's on half of her max health.
I've got 55 max health. I'll need giving a throwing attack my way. 13 damage.
Okay, this paralyzed giant that was on 37 is now down to 24. So we have, in sequence, 34, 13, 51.
You know what? Nah, go ahead. Go ahead. I need to hit the OT.
Let me just real quick check these guys' languages. Do they speak anything? Languages. Climate, terrain, frequency, organization, activity cycle, diet, intelligence, treasure, alignment, number, appearing, armor class, movement, hit die, VACO, armor, number, attacks, damage, attacks, special defenses, magic resistance, size, morale, XP. No, I don't need that. What languages they speak.
If they engage in trade, they probably speak common, but I don't know if the beast has to engage in trade much. Plains and desert probably can't speak common.
You can look at beast their intelligence head. And get a guesstimate.
Beast head giants behave in most situations like humanoid giants, but their combat tactics differ slightly. Shorter height, infrequently defending spears, rocks, clubstaves, spears, some beast head giants, blah, 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 blah. Beast heads are also capable. Beast head giants gather in smaller clans than other giants do, usually 3 to 6. Clans of beast head giants usually have all the same type of head, although some clans have members of more than one type. They feed mostly on animals. They are magical mutations of regular giants. It doesn't say anything about whether they trade with anybody. It just doesn't. Let me see. So their intelligence, treasure alignment, number appearing, armor class, movement, hit die, number attacks.
Their intelligence less than that. Bill?
I am struggling to locate that information.
That is in the stat block, whereas, you know, languages aren't necessarily.
It's usually towards the top.
Climate, terrain, frequency, organization, activity cycle, diet, intelligence. Oh, here it is. I was looking right past
it. 5 to 7.
Yep, 5 to 7.
They're smart enough to talk, so. Well, chances are at least one of them speaks broken trade common. Trader's tongue.
Yeah, we'll grant that for fun and games purposes. These guys have champion morale. What do I roll for their morale?
2d10. If you roll that number or lower, they don't break. Or, you know, that they pass the test.
Oh, they break.
Oh, nice.
I cannot believe this. The dice are just right where you need them to be tonight. I'm telling you. Yeah, here's the thing. Even if, like, you can't break the eagle-headed one through torture and he won't tell you anything, you can literally just watch the two that are retreating and they will lead you right back to their island because they think you can't get to them.
Is anyone else injured and need a heal?
Not I. Apparently that was beneath their notice.
Alright, so what?
I'm waiting for me to make a spell.
Okay.
Well, and these are beast heads. They don't have the right kind of hair to make giant hair rope out of, do they?
Yeah, they don't. But they do have what they... Well, actually, you might, you know, if you... You know, shave their bodies below their heads, but you know, if you're willing to do that, I'm just gonna stop talking about that. What beast head giants are good for is that you can get spell ingredients off them, like eagle feathers. If you take this eagle-headed giant's feathers, they count as like ingredients for Featherfall, for instance. This is a legal way of getting illegal spell ingredients, which means, you know, Lauren is going to be harvesting the crap out of me. The Veiled Alliance will pay through the nose for this kind of stuff. Ayana, roll percentile. sort of makes sense. Like, I don't, like, on the one hand, 12 Sil Giants, on the other hand, 11 extremely well-trained bull and 4 half giants with 2 armor class. Yeah, I think that fight's about even. So, about even results then. Oh, you got it again. Also, by the way, you will be able to get a few coils of giant hair rope from these non-beast-headed giants that were killed on the other front. Yeah, Fitch should be able to help them. I doubt any of them would be, like, just flat dead. I mean, there's a level where they can cycle their guys in and out. Not to mention they have, you know, they have four, they had their own Aeon, so to speak, you know? They had four people who combined can kind of maybe sort of be a little bit like Aeon.
Oh, if they'd been going for pure damage, they probably would have taken me down before I could take more than one or two of them out.
The thing is, though, they were like one or two rounds away from having you out cold and all of them on full health.
Yep. Actually, one of them took, 9 damage, but all but 2 of it was temporary.
Yeah, you got a crit. Yeah, you got a crit kicking him off of you. honestly, the reason that they're going along with you mainly is because they're just kind of scared of you, to be honest. Like, they're like kind of not sure if they could have handled you or not, and it kind of freaks them out because they've been used to being able to handle everything they come up against.
She's got a bit of a rep.
Okay. Banshee one, in the meantime, has rolled hide in shadows, and he succeeded, and he rolled move silently, and he succeeded.
Awesome.
And he is going to tail the two retreating half-giants back to their island. Roll. Giants, I'm going to say, yeah, he's going to figure it out.
He's just following him to the shore and then watching them from there, yeah. Right? Because he can't follow them to the silt.
I think it would be really great if someone runs the adventure where he gathers a team to go to the island, avenge his clutch, and save anyone who's still alive.
Okay, well, I think we're gonna call it a night. Thanks, so this was fun.
Yeah, I hope this is, sharpen my ability to make, enjoyable combat encounters. So, the first one was important units, take out the important units or suffer the consequences. This one was just a bunch of stats running. Before you go, Ayana, do you think, role-playing out that, that time where you hauled these four half giants out for drinks would be worthwhile, or do we have better things to spend our time on?
I don't know that we really need to go into it. She just basically showed them where the water barrel was, got them some water, and basically just encouraged them to stick with her and help the caravan rather than fighting it. Swap stories, all that sort of stuff.